good evening. Okay, never mind. I'll have to ask some few questions.
Okay, then what?
Okay, never mind.
Okay.
I have some few questions. The first question is, we already know you as Charles Okocha, aka Igwe Tupac, aka Mr. Accolades, aka Amoshine. But there are lots of people out there, our esteemed viewers, actually your fans, are itching to know more about you. So, just tell us more about yourself.
So basically, what I'm going to do is going to talk to
you. Any area, your style, your acting, music.
Well, first and foremost, I'm just a very sensitive. I got to have people like this, not met me. You know, the problem I was thinking about is this situation. Very egoistic. I'm so down to earth. You know what I'm saying? I don't have problems. It's not the same. The truth of the matter is, I don't like people taking my credit for us to be intimate. As long as you're cool with me, I'm cool with you. So, yeah.
Okay, next question. People actually admire your style of creativity. So, is that just who you are? Or you just do it for your fans or because of what you're trying to promote about yourself?
The truth is, I'm a very free person. Whatever it is you see that I do out there, you know, perhaps in the try to push my things. That doesn't mean I don't put it to my own side shishin and put it to the playful ways. But those crazy things you see that I do on shishin, yeah. Oh my God. God bless us.
Shine.
Okay, back to your another question. This catchphrase is of accolades, outshine. What inspired you to create this catchphrase? Shine.
Africa. Yeah, accolades, Amoshine, first of all, Amoshine was about sometime about 2 years ago, 2015, yeah, sure. No, well, that was 2016, that was after my gunshot analysis, and I was hit by six bullets. Sometimes I never did anything kind of scary. So it was after then, I was able to survive it. So even the guy that was standing close to me, where I was, I had just one bullet and one guy. But I had since, for some point, they could have survived everything. So then I just keep saying to myself, if I can survive 6 bullets, it goes to show that God has a great purpose for me. And I want to shine God bless me. It don't matter what I'm going through at that point in time, when God says it's a time, it's a time. The same thing goes out to people out there. You shouldn't be desperate until love you. In any situation you find yourself, always just keep fighting to that word, and we shine, keep saying that word, even when you know, yes, hey, you're not shining at that point, just keep saying, and trust me to come to pass to my back, and I might be, my tradition. So basically, so you know, I came out with that and straight up I went into Shove It Up Your Ass. Shove It Up Your Ass was about a fan who at some point, you know, then I was in the US last year. The guy just said something about my mom. He knows, you know, I don't joke with my mom. She's my proud mom, my first. Yeah, so, that's something I don't know more about. So when he said in a session, when he said publicly, like, he would be with that guy, this guy, I must be with you, that the mom said his man, he said something about him, and I just, I went straight up to his DM. I usually don't reply to him, he's too good, man. I don't give him a cheap voice. I just brought him straight up. But I just went for it because he has to do with my mom. So I just replied him and just told him, So that was when I came out. That was when I shoved it up your ass, you know. To the haters out there, you don't know what we artists, you don't know what we go through. You just tell them to make sure you put a smile in your faces. And what you do is come to our pages and say shit to us and insult us and stuff like that. You know, like, hey, to hear us out there, shut it up, your ass. Also, I shut up, your ass came in. And I went on to the moon. I'm like, how about that for me? This is just, and I said, this is my mom. No, no, sorry. Like, just like, so no, no actually means something new. You know what I mean? So, hey, no, no. You know, so then after that, you know, in the last one, it's accolades. So talking about accolades, basically, I never knew it was going to go viral. I didn't even have it, so I just did it, like, you know, usually where I do my things, but I never knew it was going to go this viral. You know, so Aside that, it's always good, you understand, when you work hard in life, you understand, you knew what you put in, into whatever, you know, profession you're into, you understand, and people should always give accolades to whosoever, you know, they say give props to the proper, I mean, so, but hey, some people will know that, hey, you deserve these accolades, they don't want to give it to you. Nobody wants to, you know, come on, man. So sometimes I always just accord myself my accolades. I always give myself the accolades regardless. So I just came out and I'll be like, man, I paid my dues. I've been in this industry for decades. You know what I mean? So I don't have to wait for you to give me the accolades. You know, so come on. So I had to cry a lot and I said, hey, give me my accolades. I need to let all the worldwide people know about me. So that's just basically, and also, I said that the youths, the Nigerian youths, basically, you know, I mean, all these our leaders, you know, all these politicians, so to say, who have been investing our money, you know, money and all that stuff, you know, leaving masses to go through the whole, you know, struggling, sufferings, and all that stuff. You know. So nobody should come out there and say all type of shit, you know what I'm saying? Man, hey, it's not easy. We are not like the Americans who receive salary, you know, maybe at the end of the month, at the end of the year, you just go receive your salary. You understand what I'm saying? But it's not done here. Every youth in Nigeria worked so hard to get to where they were, or where they are rather today, you know what I'm saying? Like, you are, like, you know what you're going through. It wasn't like, hey, it was actually your money, you know what you went through before you got into this media team you're into right now. Same year, where I am right now, you know what I've been through. You understand? If I start saying, okay, let's look at what Nigeria has for we the youths, so you understand, we probably won't be where we are today. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. So, but hey, we work hard, we have to work hard, come out on social media, do some crazy, some things that I'm not even supposed to do, but I come out and all because you just want to make ends meet, you know, put food on the table, make your fans smile. At the end of the day, you knew where you were headed to and all that stuff, means you're working hard. So come on. Those leaders out there should give us some accolades, you know what I'm saying? We rather have the accolades. They don't need those accolades. Because there are a bunch of criminals out there, you understand, what I'm saying? But hey, we right here, we work hard to be where we are. Do you understand what I'm saying? So we should have to do those accolades. So, man, most of the things I did, I didn't just do it because I'm doing it. All those Amoshine, Sugar Bears and everything, I didn't just do it because I'm doing it all for fun. Hey, I'm passing a message through everything that I say from the beginning of my viral content, which is Amoshine. And everything has, you know, has a message that I'm passing through, you know what I'm saying? So, hey, so that was that.
Another question. What's your expectations for the fans who are actually at the club waiting for your arrival?
Coming of Jesus Christ.
Everyone talking like that now.
Yeah, basically, it's just been like that, you know, like, yeah, that's what I see all the time. I mean, if you're not doing a good job, Oka will not want me here. And it goes to show you, so probably put a smile on your face and make it happen too. Yeah, I'm not expecting less, but I know my friends will feel me. I never have loyal friends, like die-hard friends of Charles which I hate. So, I'm not expecting anything less, man.
Okay, moving over to your iPad. Usually your viral content, your videos, the argument is always that the backstage, when I say behind the camera, all saying this, I don't know if I got that right, but all the same, I'm talking about Mr. Iman. Mr. Iman, sorry, but you know they show your face, so what's the reason why you don't reveal yourself on camera?
I say the mystery, the whole thing is interesting, isn't it? So that's what everybody's crazy about. And I try as much as possible to not please the person ahead of the goal, the concept. The concept is to inspire from behind. This is all the character that you need to see. And the person that's from behind doesn't need to show, it just gives that feedback. That's the hype man. Why kill the show?
My hype man before he came into the picture, so they, you know what I mean?
So now that he's in the picture, like, how do you feel?
Yeah, it's cool. It puts in more light to what I'm doing, you know what I mean? So that's it, you know, I appreciate it.
The last question. What's your final words to your fans or to you out there who want to actually be like you? Because there's some people out there actually putting up videos, I deserve some accolades, I'm a shine, show me love your hair. So what's your last words to your fans out there?
Yeah, first of all, like I always say, to my fans out there who are aspiring to see get even more than the level that I have been, you know, have a pace. It's always good, man. whatever it is or whatever it is, the concept, anything to them. I believe in creativity. Yeah, I believe in creativity. So basically what I'm trying to say is that it's not like being creative, you understand? It's always good in life, you understand? Find out something you know other people are not doing. Try and make a meal out of it. You know what I'm saying? Like, eat from that concept. That's what I mean. So hey, it's always good when you just keep on keeping up. Legit is always good, man. I don't believe in just really good shitty things, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, legit can come, just, it's always a gradual process. It's the one step at a time. And trust me, you'll get there. You understand? When you get there, within you, when you're eating that legit stuff, you understand? You will know, hey, this is legit, and you'll be so quite comfortable eating. You know what I'm saying? And so that's what I just keep telling my friends. So just one step at a time. Just keep on keeping on to whatever it is you're doing in life. You understand? Don't do shit it is. You know what I'm saying? And always don't forget one thing. God first, God first. God first is the end of the thing. You see, trust me. The best. You already know what I'm saying. So.
Alright, thank you so much for